Hi everyone, I'm Leo and welcome back to our App Inventor tutorials. So, remember last week we just did a very interesting app which I'm going to show you guys again here. It's a color changing app where we use very complicated functions, kind of, to randomly change the color of a canvas. So, I know that in this part there are many components that we have not covered yet in previous lessons, so that's why today I am going to talk about one of them here, this part, the for loop. So let's start now by creating a new project. I'm going to call it for loop. Okay, so in order to test things fast, we need a button and also a test label. To test, the button is going to trigger the for loop and the test label is going to show our results. So as always, just turn those tests to be larger. I don't want that the test is small as like you can't even see it on the screen, so I usually make it to like 38. And also not only about the test but also the height and the width. Okay. So we have a button and a label now. Let's move to the blocks view. Okay. We need to do the for loop when we click the button. So first component is the button cake. Then we also need to change the label, the labels tabs. So we need this set label tabs. Remember, but it's still missing something. When we click the button, we need the for loop first. The for loop is under the control tab. Here, there are two different kinds of for loop. The first one is doing the loop with number, with counting, and the second one is it loops over all the items in a list. So, we are going to talk about lists in next week lesson, so just stay tuned. Maybe we will talk about the for loop for a list after next week. So up to now we just need to know how to do this for loop, the number one. So there are a couple things that you guys should be noticed about. First is about this kind of orange thing, is the variable. So for a number loop, we need a variable to count the number of times we have been gone through. So we need a variable, the global one. The original, the initial value is not very important as we are going to change it in our loops anyway. And here we would need to do something for each loop. So in order to show the thing fast, we need to have another variables to count or to sum some numbers up. So just create a new global variable called value. And also give it an initial value to 0. And what we are going to do is we need to set our value to the sum. Right, so here the sum part, we want to add one every time we triggered the for loop. So here we need to take the value and we add one every time the loop goes in. So just get the value and we plus one every time we do the loop. So after we have completed the loop, we need to change our labels test to this value. It's very simple if you remember in some of our previous lessons. So now it's time for us to think of how we are going to implement the count loop. So here we need the variable name, and now we need to assign values so the loop knows how many times it is going to count. So the first one, the from, is talking about the initial value, the starting value. The to is talking about the ending value, and here the last one is about the interval. So if I set up a loop like this, from 1 to 5 by 1, so it is going to count from 1 to 5, and each value's interval is 1. So the number of times it is going to execute is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 times. And if our interval is set to 2, what is going to happen is, instead of counting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the loop will count from 1, 3, and 5, and only for 3 times. So we can test it right now. We need to open our emulator, and when we click the button, you can see it only counts for 3 times. So you can play with all these numbers around and try to understand how this kind of number loops is working. And loops are always useful for applications because we don't want to put every things into our apps. We need some loops to help us manage things that are going to repeat over and over. So this is pretty much about this lesson about simple number for loops in App Inventor. In next week, we are going to cover maybe some input. We're playing input finally after playing around with all these buttons. So I will see you guys next week, and just practice your coding. Bye.